my mirror. Somebody just hit me. Sideswiped me when I was going on the highway, and they took off. They're gone. I don't believe this. This is 2 days in a row. All right, we're gonna review this video. Okay, we saw that truck go by. Remember, heard straps flapping. I'm just driving in the right lane. So this was about 10 minutes ago right now. It's 8:10. Here. Nope, that's fine.
That's not it.
All right, there it is, like boom.
Yeah, 801.
1500, Dodge.
Can you pause?
So it was just 801, 802 a.m. They crossed the line and hit me. You could see clearly in the camera. Then he got in front of me. All right, someone went flying by there. Here comes another SUV, and it's right after this. See, I'm in the lane. You can see I'm in my lane. That's the important thing here.
Yeah.
There, the car was behind me. The truck was behind me. Comes up, and it purposely just hits me. You can see that. Then the mirror is damaged. Purposely just rammed me like that. The ram rammed me. All right, this is right where it happened. You can see the vehicle here. It was behind me, and it got up, and I guess it didn't like that I had to pass me. That's all I can think of. And then it hit me. And there's no front plate on it. It must be from Florida. So you can see clearly here that the driver is over the line or about to cross it and hit me. This is where the driver hits me. I'm clearly in my lane. All right, that happened so fast. I tried to stop it, and I think it messed up the video for a split second. Where's the front? And in this shot, I don't think we even see the driver yet. Let's see. Well, yeah, he sideswiped me real good. The whole side of the car. Yeah, everything. This is all damaged. That's damaged. That's damaged, obviously. The door, even the Falcon Wing door, all dented in, smashed up. I gotta get on the phone with the police as soon as I try to get a plate off of this. Here's another shot of the video. This is as close as I can get. Okay, so I pulled the USB thumb drive out of here and we played the videos here. We did some screenshot captures. Denise showed me how to do it. It was control print screen, and then we went over to Paint and we did control V to turn it into an image on Paint, and then we saved it. You can save it as a high resolution image. We gotta try to pull the plate off. One of them, the license plate, I still don't know, but you can go to File and then Save As, and then BMP, I think, which is the highest resolution, or PNG. I did both of those. And now we're just trying to transfer the files is what we're trying to do. We have to do all this investigative work. The sheriff's over here, but you know, he doesn't have anything to go on until we get him that license plate number. So we're trying to determine that, see if we can get that now. Look how big that file is, the bitmap. That's what you want. Or send, hopefully you can send these over right now. All right, send. Okay, I'm gonna try to take this mirror off. I can't drive like this. We're gonna try to fasten something because this is gonna fall out. It's not gonna last much longer. Maybe some cardboard in there. Try to take this off. I've gotta remove the door panel, I think, on the inside first. So if I can do that, I'm actually gonna make a video on how to do that, because otherwise I gotta cut the wire right there, which might short circuit something. So there's a wire harness that's holding it on, basically. But there's a disconnect on the inside. All right, I've got a Tesla Model X 2017. I have some damage, as you can see. Someone did a hit and run on me, and this mirror is flopping. So I have to get this door panel off so that I can not have to clip this electrical thing here and possibly short circuit stuff. I want to disconnect from the inside. So in order to do that, I have to take the panel off. First thing you want to do is pull this pad up. You need a little tool to dig into it. And it uncovers a 10 millimeter bolt in there. So you gotta get, that's holding the panel on, and then this trim, which I just did with a screwdriver, pulled it out a little bit. Just be very careful. You should have a pry tool, but I have a screwdriver. It does the same thing if you're very careful and kind of finesse it without breaking this, you got to work it. I'm gonna put the camera down so that I can get this done properly, but basically this has to come off because underneath here are more 10 millimeter bolts, and that's all that holds the door panel on. Then you pull it off from there with the clips. It's just held on by clips from there. So to give you more detail, about a third of the way in, see, there's this rigid push clip. You have to push down on that silver right there, and then it releases apparently. I haven't done this before, but this is one of the tricks. You see, down there, and it pops out. There you go. So you gotta know that, otherwise something might break. And then it comes out the rest of the way. You see, like this? And then it's gonna uncover the 10 millimeter bolts that we have to undo. There's a couple of them in there, you can see. So let's get to taking those off. There you go, 10 millimeter right in there. There's one right there. Almost at the end here. Don't drop them in there, you gotta be real careful. Here's what it looks like. It's easy enough to drop it in there, so don't do that. There's one right there, one next to it on the right, and then there's one in there. You gotta pull the handle back. That's gonna be hard to get to, so that's three, and then four, right down in there. See, this one is a pain. You gotta hold this handle back while you stick your socket in, and you gotta keep your knee on the door because the door wants to go in when you do that. And then just kind of turn it loose by hand once you get it free, like I did, and then make sure not to drop the bolt in there and pull it out. So we got that one out, and then the last one is right down in here. All right, so I've got all three of these bolts out here, the fourth in there, and basically everything's held on my clips. You have to pry it off of here as a thing, and all the clips will come off, but the first one is the hardest. That's what I'm gonna try to do. And you should start in this corner from what I've seen. Well, in the process of this, I had to take the glass off. It was about to fall off anyway. But I really need to get in here to get these, like I said, door panel off to get to these electrical wires in there so I can unplug them from the harness. All right, so I get this tool. It's angled so I can pry up, and it needs a lot of force. I was trying the screwdriver, it wasn't doing it. It's gonna need a lot of force to break these first clips free. Well, I was able to get some off, but I broke one, unfortunately. I can see it right there already. It was this one, see? That one broke. This one came off. The clip came off, you can see there? The way it's supposed to. The rest of it, hopefully, is just more like finessing it to pull the panel out. All right, see, the whole thing eventually comes off like that. And then at the top, okay, there, it drops down. Whoop, that didn't sound good. Whoa, okay, that wasn't me, that was Denise, okay. Now, the mirror though, the assembly, like is back in here. Gotta figure this out. Okay, if you are removing and replacing your mirror, your side mirror, your glass unit, which I need to do because it's broken, after you take the door panel off, and I have a video on that, you need this 720T27, I think, is what it is. And you've got these steel bolts. There's four of them. There's one, show you right here. There's one here. There's one tucked behind here. You see it there? And then there's two more
up underneath here. And I think that holds the entire assembly. The whole assembly should pull out. And the electrical connection appears to be anyway right here. See these two connections? And then the wire running through and into that area. But take these off and you need a lot of torque to spin these. I got two of them off already. Make sure you use the right size. And these are steel bolts into aluminum panels on the door and the exterior. So don't over tighten them when you do tighten them. And here, I'll see if I can show you how hard it is to get this thing to break free. Like, this is whenever you first take something off, it's always so harder. Let's see. This, I'm probably gonna, yeah, I can't get the torque. I need two hands on this to force it. And it finally goes when you feel like it's not gonna go at all. It finally goes. Okay, this is the connection for these two, for the mirror over here. So I disconnected that. I pulled this tape off, the insulating tape, and I've got to pull this off in order to feed these cables through to get them out the other end. I've got to do that, so. Okay, so once you unbolt those, and that was, I think, an 8mm. Yeah, 8mm. Then you can pull it back. And you can feed the, you can push the cables through here. And then again, for this mirror thing, we got all the bolts off, all four of them. See, they're all taken out. And this whole assembly should come out at this point too. Okay, I was able to pull these out more so I can see that these are the wires that are connected. Because when I pull on them, you see, they move. They get put up in the door. So that's really what all I need to do. I'm gonna just cut these off and wait till the entire new assembly, I get it from Tesla. Okay, so when I get the new parts from Tesla, they're gonna go in here. For now, I'm just gonna let this thing loose. I'm gonna cut these wires off so we're not gonna have any mirror dangling on the side of the car. We're gonna put our little patch here for the glass until we get that part from Tesla. And then the panel goes on in reverse order to make sure that this came off, which attaches down here for the latch. Make sure that goes on before you put the door back on, and of course, put these bolts back on. And that's it. Okay, so door panel is back on. That does work. Yeah, I can hear it. Okay, got that connected. Put the bolts back on, the trim back on. Now the cutting fun begins. Just a nice little steak knife to cut. Pretty much done there. Okay, so I cut it all off. This might get some water in it, but oh well. And we are good till I get another unit from Tesla. Like, I kind of got bashed. That's my blood, actually, my finger. It got on there. Nice. All right, so here's our patch for now. I hope it holds up. I gotta turn off the auto presenting doors. Just won't use that door. Won't use this door for a while till I get this thing fixed.